If I can't see the red, it's pointless. So.
Yeah.
And he was like, oh, I got this other life proof something or other. You can see a little bit of the red in this one.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel.
Really?
Yes. You just start.
No. Start over.
Okay, we're starting over.
You have to tell the person who's okay. with you that we're starting. Like some kind of heads up. Besides, right? Oh, it's already recording. By the way, I'm like, do I have food in my teeth?
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Erica. I'm here with my sister Raylan. This is Raylan. Yay! I'm so excited that she decided to be or agreed to be, involuntarily on my channel.
More like friendly force.
Just a little bit. She loves me, so that's good.
Love.
That's good.
On Siblings Day. Hey, what do you know?
Hey, I didn't even think about that. Anyways, I'll try to get this uploaded by like tomorrow. We'll see.
We might make it.
The whole reason I wanted her to be on with me today is because I got this awesome box that has some face masks in it from Hydroxytone. Oh.
Big words.
Hydroxytone. I'm not very good with big words. Anyways, so we are going to have some girl time and put on some face masks.
Yay! Everybody likes to look at scary people with face masks on. It's not even Halloween.
I don't know much about these face masks because I left the paper at home that has all the information on them. However, I do know that they sell them at Kohl's, and let's see, what does that one say? It's for
Powered Hydration Recovery. But this is an active infusion moisture mask, so this must be, can we open it?
Yeah.
Okay.
And this is a deep moisture serum sheet mask.
All right. Oh, this must be one like lotion, that you leave on? And then it like hardens a little bit, or you know what I'm talking about?
So, I thought maybe we can put these on, and then we can play a game while they're on our face.
Oh, guys, I don't know what I got.
Answer some questions.
All right.
Although I haven't picked out the game yet.
Is there more than one? Oh, there's several. Huh. Erica can get her face nice and, what did it say? Deeply moisturized. Like
which I
four
do
times.
Need because
one
I
have to go home with us.
Oh, one has to go with
mom. Yeah. Yeah. Which so. I have very dry skin anyways. Don't you have
yep,
dry skin
I do.
Too? So they should be perfect for both of us.
Because, as it says, skin is healthy and maintains both its elasticity and strength when it's properly hydrated. I think we need that elasticity
Usage
and strength.
Usage instructions. Gently remove the mask from pouch. Carefully unfold the mask and apply it to cleaned face, which we just cleaned our face. Well, I cleaned it with this and she had her. Remove the mask from face and discard after 10 minutes.
Oh,
so we get 10 minutes.
All right.
We get 10 minutes to play a game. So let's push pause while we find the dog and we find a game and then we'll be back. I'm just kidding. We're back. This is what makes making videos fun because you just kind of do whatever you want to do. And she's such a perfectionist, so she's very like,
don't get me started.
You have to, yes. So we decided while I turned off the camera to do the parenting controversial tag, which both of us are kind of confused why it's controversial, but we're gonna put these face masks on and we're gonna kind of just answer the questions and see. Some of y'all might like not like the answers, obviously, because not everybody agrees with things. And I think we kind of parent our kids a little
very
bit the
similar.
Same, very similar. We have a lot of the same opinions, but
you want to know what I'm just realizing?
What?
I don't have a thing for my hair.
Oh, go get one.
Get that.
Go get one. Oh, I have.
I was just we can ring a fiesta here in San Antonio a little bit early.
A little early.
No, I'll go get a hair before.
I was at Walmart and in San Antonio, Fiesta is very, very big. So I'm taking pictures of Ryan tomorrow, hopefully, fingers crossed, if it doesn't rain. And so I thought it'd be really fun to get this little instead of me making one, this was like $5. Why not? And it goes around your head like this. Oh, it's so cute. And then I also got something else while she's getting that. Pass me the thing, Mom. That little thing. Is it a dog?
It's a donkey.
Oh.
It's a Fiesta, Eric. It's a donkey.
It's Fiesta, duh. Check out the donkey. Guys, look at this thing. It is so cute. And look at him. Has a little tail. This is $5 too. Well, it kind of looks like a coyote.
It's a donkey, honey.
It looks like it could be a dog. Like a muzzled dog.
Look, Erica.
It's a muzzled dog.
I just did this thing online, you know, on Facebook. And it's find out who your road trip crew is. And for Erica, it says, sleep the whole drive. If that's not the truth.
Oh my word, it is.
I would sleep. I love to take road trips.
Because she sleeps.
She's not a good shotgun rider. Not at all. She needs to be fired from that.
She used to always say, I'll drive, Mom.
My
husband, and then the next thing I know, she's going, well, Mom, can you drive? I'm kind of tired. And that's it.
You know, on a two-hour trip, it's not a big deal. But when you're like a 4 or 5,
those are the best
trip.
Trips because then you just fall asleep. And
when you get there,
you wake up
and you're there.
Not the best for the driver. Not very fair. No, the shotgun rider is supposed to be the navigator. They're supposed to help with that. Cool. And they're supposed to help adjust the radio. Mm-hmm. They're supposed to keep the tunes going.
And read the text messages.
And that too. And this day and age, that too.
Yeah. Oh. Okay, so right back if you need to.
No, I'm going to put it on you.
Oh. And then I'm going to put it on you?
Sure.
All right.
Okay, it says...
It's very fluid.
Yes. I feel like we're going
to
get...
Very, I hesitated to say the word moist. It's like a big controversy these days, too.
It's a moisturizer mask.
Have y'all seen that thing on that's circulating with all the famous people saying moist?
No, I have not.
Well, anyway. So
this is very...
It's very wet.
I don't know if you can see my fingers because the lighting's not great, but...
Wet seems like it would be worse than moist.
This totally says, do not get in your eyes.
Wow. Okay, I'll close my eyes, and then you can position it.
How are we not supposed to get this in our eyes?
Which side goes on the nose?
I think they both have the same amount of fluid on it.
Yeah, it's hard to tell.
This is like meat juice.
Well, I think because the...
That's meat juice.
I think because the flaps are, like, creases are like this down here, I think this side should go on my face. I see a lot of...
Oh my goodness.
Yes, I was telling Mom the other day that I hate, like...
Erica, be careful how you say it, because
it's meat juice. It's meat juice.
My mind just went...
I'm sorry, some people have dirty minds. Not you guys, YouTube.
Right, of course not. Nobody that we know.
I hate it when I, like, take meat out of the package, and it's all, like, juicy. Okay, that did not come off wrong.
I'm scared right now.
Okay. Don't get it in your
eyes.
I'm going
to close my eyes, I think, maybe.
Don't close your eyes.
Okay, I won't. Oh, it's on my lip. I feel more like... Wow. Okay, I'm pretty sure this is like straight out of a horror movie. Yeah. I'm auditioning right after this. Look for me. How much liquid is... on these, man, they are serious about the hydration factor here. There is no part of this that's dry anyway. So, all right, I'll see if I can be as delicate to Erica as she was
gentle
with me.
Gentle.
Yeah, I'm gonna put it right in her eyeball. Okay, I try not to pick your nose. All right.
Yes, that's morbid. I'm sorry.
While Mom is doing that, we're going to start our parenting controversial topics. The first one. This is controversial.
This is.
Okay. Oh, the first question is, are we pro-life or are we pro-choice? I'm going to keep it very simple and very plain. I am personally, which I think Raylan is too, both pro-life. And we're just going to leave it at that because that is a very controversial topic. And that's what we believe and that's how we feel. And we're just going to leave it there. The other ones, however, I don't see how
less
they
less controversial
are.
For us as moms, I think.
Yes. Baby wearing.
I do have some experience with this. I only did it with one out of four of my biological children.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. She has five kids.
Yes.
There's that.
Yeah. I have three teenagers right now. Y'all feel sorry for me. Not really. I'm kidding. I mean, I do have three teenagers, but you don't need to feel sorry for me. I'm fine with baby wearing. I mean, do what works for you, right? I mean, we're just trying to raise our kids up and get them out of the house. So whatever works for you as a baby, whatever gets you through the day, that's what I say. Whatever makes mom and baby happy.
Yeah, I wore Ryan, my third, my baby girl, all the time. And I was actually kind of sad that I didn't know about baby wearing before, like with the boys.
Yeah, you were super good at it.
Yeah, I loved it. I thought it was amazing.
I watched her and I was like, man, I wish I could have another baby so I could try this again.
Just to do it over.
I'm not having any more babies.
Which kind of brings us into, circumcision.
I'm pro-circumcision. I already know all the pros that people will tell you for non-circumcision. However, I just don't want to deal with that. I'm not working to clean that mess for a while. Sorry. I'm not doing that. And there are other reasons, but that's just my own selfish reason. I don't want to deal with that. So, no. Cut it off.
Cut it off.
Lose the extra skin.
Look at her go. She does not care.
But if that's not what you feel, go ahead and do you.
Yeah. Again, I feel I'm not pro or against circumcision. I know what I have my children. I guess I've never really read into all of the reasons why you shouldn't get circumcised other than like it's not his choice. He doesn't get to make the choice himself.
Well, there's like cleanliness issues, hygiene issues,
yeah,
because
I mean,
there's extra skin. You
those
have to
normal
be careful.
Stuff.
When they're older, sensation.
But why
and
do
like
people?
That. But as a mom, you don't need to be into all that with
yeah.
your kid.
But why? Why do people? Why are people so against it, though?
I don't know. It is some loud crying, but it's over quick.
Like because it hurts
well,
the child.
For some people, it's a religious thing.
Well, I mean, I guess.
Well, and then for some people, there's
religious
thing
yeah.
to get
yes.
it done.
She got mad at me for putting my 2-year-old in timeout. So. Just like, she's okay. not learning anything.
Well, if you saw her little face, and I'm sure you'll have on videos, come on, y'all. She does not need to go in timeout. Poor baby girl.
You're no, just an aunt.
It makes me sad. Yeah, aunts have a different viewpoint, but when it comes to your own kids, as far as spanking goes, I'm not against it anyway. I'm a proponent. However, being that I do have 5 kids, ranging in ages from 16 down to 3, I can say that this thing slides and I can't talk. Every child is different and responds different.
Agreed.
To various types of discipline. I have some that if you look them in the eye and give them a stern look and talk with a stern voice, they turn that behavior right around. I've got another one that, I mean, I could spank all day long and that would not have any effect on them at all. Others just need a quiet, separate talking to. So again, it's all about figuring out what works for you and your family and what's going to be best for you and your kid. But I'm not, I would never advocate for beating your child. And I think that if you're acting or reacting out of anger when you do the discipline, then that's when you probably need to look in the mirror and figure out what's wrong with your mask. That's probably where you're getting to a line that probably doesn't need to be crossed and you probably need to reevaluate some of that. So I always say everything has to be done in a proper manner. So if I spank, it's with after a cool down period. And then it's done out of love, it's done out
with
of conversation.
Love, yes.
And then there's always it's always coupled with prayer and a hug and a kiss and a reiteration of why we're doing it, and it's not because they're a bad kid. It's just to help them make better choices in the future. And it's because we love them.
Bam. Adoption.
Really? I this is what I don't see as why would this would be controversial at all. There are so many kids that need homes.
Oh my goodness.
So many people that can't have babies that want babies. So I don't know.
I would adopt an RV now, and I have 3 kids, so. And I guess, would you adopt right now if you could? I mean, you have 5 kids. It's a hard choice. We want to foster.
Maybe if they were older.
Well, I don't know. I'm not, I mean, I've never really thought about it because I have so many of my own kids. I don't know. I guess if the right situation came up or God put it on our heart to do that, then obviously we'd be open to that. But just as a general rule, I got one that's 2 years away from leaving the nest and one that's about to start pre-K. So bringing more children into this home is not really at the forefront of my thoughts at the moment.
And on the other hand, see, I feel like God has put it on Jared and I's heart to foster, to adopt. And not just adopt, but to take children that are already older, like 5 or 6, and put them into a home that need loving and caring and somebody that's going to show them what a family is truly like. So definitely pro adoption and foster caring if you have that in your heart and God has placed that on your heart. We are totally do it. Breastfeeding.
Do it. Or do not. It.
Or.
No, look, I have 5 kids. 4 that I delivered myself, 2 I breastfed, 2 I did not. So again, you never know. I mean, I think everybody goes into their pregnancy, labors, deliveries with like a certain plan in mind, but you know, things at some point just take turns that maybe are unforeseen.
Well, there are things that happen because
I had a kid in the NICU that I couldn't,
I never dropped milk to
get anything for.
Nothing. I couldn't have.
That's why I wasn't my first. I could pump for 30, I could nurse for 30 minutes and she'd still cry. So then I'd pump for another 30 minutes and I'd get nothing. I tried. And after 6 weeks of being miserable, her and I, then we just both said, you know what?
Yeah.
We're gonna get us on a path where everybody's a little bit happier. And then I've had kids that I did till they were a year and had 100% success. So
I miss breastfeeding.
It is a great bonding experience.
I totally miss it.
Yeah.
With my first, I couldn't, and that was sad, but I did for like 2 weeks, and that was it. And then my second one quit breastfeeding at like 5 months. His choice, not my choice. That was totally all him. It's his fault. And then Ryan, I breastfed for a year, and I miss it. I wish I would have continued, but you know, you look back and you miss it. At the time, I was like, I'm so over breastfeeding. Yeah. So it goes both ways. We have one more, and then we're going to take these masks off. We have 2 more. Cry it out.
I let my kids cry it out.
Cry it out.
I don't really have any, like, sage advice or reasoning for it. I think it was just something that somebody close to me probably said, oh, just let them cry it out. And I said, okay, I'll try that. And I did. And then I had success with it in a very short period of time. I don't think if it went on for months, hours, I would keep doing that. Or, you know, it took like 3 days with one of my kids. So, I mean, that to me is a very,
it's
you know,
kind of like
limited time
in
the greater
my face itches
aspect of life. But
does my face look beautiful?
It looks super hydrated.
Does it?
And wet.
It looks very wet, but I'm going to take my cleansing cloth.
And can we do that?
Wipe all of it off. Are you supposed to like rub it in?
I don't know.
What's the direction say?
Gently
pat. Probably should have.
Oh, this is not moisture, people. It's essence.
Essence.
It says right here on the box.
Oops.
Gently pat any essence remaining in the pouch onto your skin. Well, so there we go. We don't have to use moist. We don't have to use fluidy or liquidy or wet.
It's essence.
So we're supposed to pat that on our face. Well, I already folded it up, so I'll see what I can do.
It just makes it more wet. I want the wetness off.
I know. I'm not sure about that.
Can we just, I'm going to rub it in.
Can we just like fan our face dry?
I don't know.
So, to answer your question, I let my kids cry it out.
I'm sorry, I dropped the tone. I have to wipe off my face because it's, can you see this? Look, let's see if we can zoom in. Can you see it? It's all, nope, it's not zoom, oh, it's not focusing.
There you go.
It's all over, like, it's all over my face.
That's not on the box.
Well, once my face dries and I can actually like rub my face and tell you how my face feels.
Yeah. It says to use this at least once a week.
So
there must be something in the essence.
Let's let our face dry and finish our last two things.
Erica, did you let your kids cry it out? I think Ryan was probably harder.
Ryan was a lot harder. Because Ryan still sleeps in her crib in our room. As I've mentioned before, we live in a little small two-bedroom condo, and I couldn't let her cry it out with me in the room. Like, I don't know. I feel like cry it out only works for, like, a certain stage, like an age group, because once they get old enough to realize, like, what you're doing, or mommy's going to come in the room no matter what, like, they're smarter than you think they are. Like, there's only a time frame. So for Nolan, I definitely did, but Nolan wasn't like in a crib. We put him in a bed at 1 year old because he climbed out of his crib.
He's a Houdini.
And so he was able to get up and walk around the room and kind of like soothe himself, and it didn't take long. Luke, I don't remember. I don't think Luke had that issue. I think we definitely gave him a bottle a little bit longer than we should have. And the same with Ryan, but I'm not against crying it out. I don't think you should let your kids cry all night long and not go check on them, period. But I think there's definitely a way to go about it, a good way to go about it and a wrong way to go about it. And I think that you just need to do your research and you do you.
Yeah, that's my like tagline.
You do you. Yeah. So I think that's definitely how I feel about it. And the last thing I do have a strong opinion on is co-sleeping.
Just say no.
I just don't know.
That's my strong opinion.
Is that how you feel?
Just say no.
I didn't know what her
thing
about it is.
Let me quantify that.
What are we talking about?
I'm saying just say no to the like all night. Like your kid goes to bed, you go to bed, y'all together just from start to finish. No. I'm against that. My kids were the kind that as soon as they could sleep through the night, they got moved out into their own room. That's how we did that. So that was usually between 3 and 4 months for all of my kids, I think, pretty much.
Lucky. My kids didn't sleep till like 2 years.
I did have one of those. I still moved him out because at some point I can't listen to... He just didn't sleep anyway, ever, even during the day. But anyway, back to what I was saying. Now, if you're like me and your kids get up for school and then you still have a baby, so it's like 6 o'clock in the morning, but you're not really ready to start your day because you stay at home, they go back to sleep with you till like 8:30. That I'm definitely down with. Makes mornings a little bit more bearable.
For me, I worked at a hospital for like 3 years, and then I heard horror stories when I was pregnant with Nolan from my crazy doctor. I'll have to tell you about that another time. And then just working at the hospital and hearing stories of parents accidentally falling asleep on their newborns terrified me. And I still totally, even if you feel like you're a light sleeper, like, babies are so sensitive and so small. You just don't know what will happen in the middle of the night if you're sleeping.
They like the warmth, so that's why they scoot up.
Yeah, they scoot up to you. You know, even with moms, I've heard of stories where moms are breastfeeding and they fall asleep and suffocate their baby on accident. And it's not something that, I don't know, it's such a horrible outcome to a stuff that happens, and I'm not even going to go into it, but Ryan is 2.5, and she definitely got in bed with me this morning at 7 o'clock for like an hour. So I think it's an age thing. Newborns, absolutely not. I don't agree with it. 2 years old, heck, if I get an extra hour of sleep, I'm all for it.
Yeah. Whatever gets you the extra time.
Extra hour, yeah. In the middle of the night, oh no. Mommy and daddy need their time to be together.
Yeah, at Ryan's age, though, she's probably a lot like my youngest.
sleeps
it's
all
night. Yeah. Well, she sleeps all night, but then it's, you know, she gets up in the morning and then comes and gets in my bed. Now she's not really sleeping, but I can still lay there and kind of take my time to, you know, to get wake up or whatever. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
But I don't know what my excuse will be here in, you know, 5 or 6 months when she starts school.
You're not going to have one.
No, I'll have to get up and do something, I guess.
Okay, guys. So, anyways, it's been a while. Overall, the Hydroxytone Deep Moisture Serum Sheet Mask was a little uncomfortable to put on for 10 minutes. It was very cold. My face is...
so cold, my face.
It's not as sticky as it was, but... it's definitely not dry.
Yeah, I didn't wipe mine off, so mine's a little sticky.
But my face isn't dry, though. Like it doesn't feel dry.
No.
Yeah. Like, at all. And my fingers are very, ooh, very, very...
soft.
Baby yes. soft. Yes, so
like a baby's bottom. Very smooth.
If in, like, 10 minutes my face feels like my fingers feel, I am all for it. I can handle that for 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Once a week. So... we did not try this one. I'm going to leave this one here with Raylan.
Oh, thanks.
And yay. Let her try it. And then I will ask her, and I don't know if I will get back to you on YouTube about it, but I will try to do an Instagram story or something just to let you guys know what she thinks.
Awesome.
And are you excited about that? I'm surprised Cassidy isn't here.
She is. She's upstairs.
Oh, she didn't want
to. They're having standardized testing this week, so they're all taking it easy. And I think they wanted to go to bed early because they actually don't have to be up as early tomorrow because none of them have anything going on before school.
So pray for her children. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button. Let us know. Please no hate comments. I know that some people don't agree with some of the things that we said. However... these are our opinions and that's how we feel, and I apologize if you don't agree, but that's just life and not everybody's going to agree with you.
It's all love from this end.
Yeah.
No hate.
We love you. Thank you so much for watching.
Thanks
and
for letting me be a part.
And I can't wait till we get to see you again with Raylan, and I'll see you probably for my husband's birthday party.
Friday.
Yay! Okay, bye guys. Have a good night.